Welcome back, everybody. Game number four. That's right, Complexity. If you're watching game one and two and you checked out for a game, I can totally understand that you're surprised that the series is still going. But Complexity had it in them. They turned around this series by being able to pick up a win. And a lot of the narrative seemed to be about some of the early pressure they put on Digital Chaos. DC didn't seem to feel very comfortable with that. And maybe that means that's the winning formula for Complexity to be able to turn this whole entire series around. We'll have to see. We head into the draft now for game number four. And you're not going to hear too much of my co-caster because I started this broadcast hoping that our Scarp issues would be resolved. Since Blitz Dota, he did not want to fly and travel and be away from home for yet another event. So he's at home in Germany right now and not connecting to my call. So you're going to have a solo cast for the time being. We're going to have a Riki and Riki first pick here for Complexity. The first time we're going to see the Riki into the pool here, while the other four positions, both the Bounty Hunter as well as the Earth Spirit were taken away quite early. It's going to be a Lifestealer, and the vehicle for the Lifestealer will be the Batrider. Now, Batrider, when it comes to the offlaners, hasn't been the most highly prioritized. When it comes to pick priority, hasn't been like first pick or 1-2 too many times. Maybe that's just because the myriad of counters there is from defensive supports, all of which are quite popular right now, such as Eventual Spirit, Oracle, and NA, pretty popular as well. But we're not going to see any of those heroes, despite the danger that Batrider presents here. I guess if he's going to be carrying the Lifestealer around, that is perhaps maybe a different kind of threat. But they're going to go for the Beastmaster on Complexity. They enjoyed having that one in their hands. This time around, the Beastmaster last game from Digital Chaos was a four position. Here for Complexity, it is pretty clearly going to be a Swindle's offlane beast. Just because of the fact they've got that four position Riki that's going to be roaming around the game. We'll see whether or not they try and make the laning phase work at all by having Z-Freak down in that bottom lane with Swindles. Something tells me, though, that is unlikely, and they're just going to use the Riki to try and harass and keep the Batrider in check inside of his jungle and hopefully force him into lane where they can easily kill him with that extra support, which we don't know his or her name just yet. Winter Wyvern's going to be banned away by Complexity. We'll have the Juggernaut taken out by Digital Chaos. Juggernaut, very popular in NA right now. Very commonly being picked up in the 3-4 position. Offers you quite a bit. There's still the possibility for it to be able to run mid. Reserve time. And match up against some heroes like the Timbersaw, for example. Complexity. But otherwise, it's going to be a safe lane farming hero, but there's even some versatility to the item builds you go. You know, there's a lot of different things that that Juggernaut can do, and that's just the versatility of the pick. Sorry, guys, I'm trying to fix Skype right now. Reserve time. Death Prophet, gonna be banned away. I'm trying to communicate to people right now. Let's see if we could get this fixed. Anyway, I've called for help. I've lit the bat sign in the air. Hopefully K-Poptosis will come rescue me from the living nightmare that is solo casts. In a grand finals. Timbersaw going to be the fourth ban away. At this point in time, Timbersaw would have been a pretty good mid. Riki is not quite enough to fully kick it out of lane, that's for sure. Obviously, because he's putting out physical damage and reactive armor, etc., etc. But the silence can be really effective against the Timber. But it doesn't matter. We talked about this, Blitz and I. The Timbersaw does seem to be fully back in the meta, and he seems strong enough that he can actually ignore his mid matchup. It used to be when Timbersaw was first intrepidly being picked up. It was versus the Alchemist mids. Full-on counter there. And then as we experience more and more Timbersaw, people really got to feel the range of that hero and what it can deal with. It started being picked up against more and more matchups besides the Alchemist, picked up against certain ranged heroes. And then next thing you know, it's gotten so strong in the minds of the players that it's now being picked up before it even knows what it's matched up against mid. It's like, it doesn't matter. I'm Timbersaw. I'll make it work. Dazzle is going to be the choice here from Digital Chaos. They will get themselves a saving hero. We saw the success of Dazzle for Alliance, actually. The Weave coming in at critical times for them in the late game. Wonder what that means, though, for their mid position and why they really feel like they need a saving hero. Either way. Still waiting on DC's fourth pickup now. Disruptor goes the way of Complexity. Not terribly surprising. We now have double AoE silences versus a Lifestealer, plus the lockdown of the Beastmaster. Honestly, this Lifestealer is getting incredibly countered. If this was Kuro, I would say that they could do something crazy like run a Lifestealer 4 position or something in the jungle. Just to, you know, because the Lifestealer feels so countered that I'm not sure how much. You definitely need some sort of scaling mid because you cannot have a single core Lifestealer 90% of games. And then it just becomes all the worse that this Lifestealer is incredibly well countered. So what kind of scaling mids are there left? Well, there's a Phantom Lancer mid still up in the air. The Invoker was banned away rather early on by Complexity in that 1-2 area. Same goes with Death Prophet. Damn, there is just...
Reserve time.
All right. The bat signal ain't working, guys. Hold on. Alfred forgot to pay the goddamn electric bill. Why Rubick, though? Another really defensive support. I really don't like Dazzle and Rubick most of the time, just because I feel like you don't have a whole lot of damage output. There's a little bit of disables. There's some saving mechanisms here, but it's a super defensive support duo. You have maybe Static Storm or Roar that you can steal. I don't see a whole lot of strength to this Rubick pickup, and it's rather curious to me.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Why they would pick this up, but maybe all will be revealed. Oh, the Terror Blade! We actually didn't, with that 3-4, it's been missing for a while. It finally actually made it through the banning area, and we'll see it in the draft. So, all right. Master K-Pop Tosis is here to solve all of our woes.
5 seconds remaining.
Now just waiting on the fifth band. Still need a scaling mid. What do we got? All right, now I can actually pull up Dota 2 heroes. Kind of jog my memory here of what kind of mids. Oh, there's the Lone Druid mid. The Weeha Lone Druid mid? Would that be any good? I don't know if I like it versus Terrorblades. I don't know if that like the sound of that one. Timbersaw taken away. Oh man, this is a rough one.
10 seconds remaining.
Do something weird. Some sort of morphling mid.
Turn to ban.
I still don't know what their mid matchup is either. Oh, Alchemist. DC actually banned that one away themselves. Storm Spirit.
10 seconds remaining.
Storm Spirit versus two. Disruptor. There's no way.
5 seconds
that ain't working either. Legion Commander. It's got to be something weird. Ember Spirit. I mean, that still would have been a little bit dangerous against Riki and Disruptor, but I could see where they're going with the Terrorblade in their hands. Want to make sure... Tinker? Again? Beastmaster, Disruptor, Riki, that sounds rough. Honestly, I'm not really feeling Digital Chaos's lineup too much. I'm not sure what their fifth pick is going to be, but I don't have a whole lot of faith in it, no matter what it is. The Wind Ranger will be picked up, though, by Complexity Gaming. I think all they really needed to be able to have was a nice, again, another hero to be able to deal with Lifestealer, because we can't really seem to get a grasp on what the mid could possibly be. SF.
Reserve time. 5 seconds remaining.
3, 2, 1. It's the Lone Druid Weeha mid. All right. That was one of the first heroes we suggested, but wasn't a fan. I think Complexity probably knew this was going to be coming up. I think that was the most, out of all the heroes I listed, and I was like, all right, that hero. And I was like, no, God, no. That hero, God, no. The most mild negative reaction was the Lone Druid. So in that regard, it is the least of all evils. You could say that much. All right, my technicians are back in play. We fixed the problem. You guys are lifesavers. I wish I had you guys all the time. We'll have Blitz Dota coming in very shortly, and he can give us the real draft analysis. But right now, my draft analysis is that Digital Chaos's draft is... But we'll see. Maybe I'm totally off the marker here. Lone Druid mid versus Wind Ranger. Oh, man, we can't even do the prediction game. Oh, wait, Blitz Dota?
Hello.
Hello!
Your Skype died.
I know. The internet went down on our second computer, but I had to go through draft all by myself. Do you want to do predictions? Do you want to get your say in on the draft analysis?
DC will win.
Oh, you really like their draft that much?
Yeah. Do you like Cole's draft?
I thought I liked Cole's draft because I had a hard time deciding what mid DC could pick up because I thought Weeha Lone Druid was the most... All the other mids I could think of were just kind of like bad versus this lineup of Complexity. Because they needed a scaling mid, right? Because Lifestealer's pretty heavily countered.
You think so?
I thought so with Disrupt. I mean, they've got two AoE silences. They've got a Beastmaster. They've got Terrorblade. Terrorblade's really good versus Lifestealer too. Isn't that four counters at least? And Wind Ranger's not bad versus Lifestealer. Isn't that five counters of Lifestealer?
No, dude. DC got this.
All right. Well, see, this is why you don't let Cap do draft analysis by himself.
Okay. I figured out what the issue is. We're good.
Okay. Glad to hear it.
I'm hyped. If they can somehow turn this series around, that would be very exciting.
You got to break down the draft for me though. What is good about DC's? How did they actually win this one? Cuz you got to open my eyes here, Blitz Dota.
I think their ways to find fights are a little bit harder than Complexity's, because Complexity has a Riki
right.
and a Beastmaster, so they're always going to have the vision advantage.
Okay.
But I think laning phase-wise, DC does fine, and I think that their two supports are well-matched for this game. Like, I'm okay with everything that they have so far.
You're good with the Rubik time. Dazzle? I thought we agreed that we weren't fans with that.
I'm normally not, but I think if you're against a Riki and against a TB and stuff like that, then it's quite decent. And more importantly, the number one thing against Terrorblade is you want to pressure his lane.
Yeah.
By going aggro with this kind of tri-lane, there's nothing that Cole can do. They can bring every hero up here, and they wouldn't make a difference.
Okay. I am fully in support of that. I didn't really, because I was, you know, trying to solve the issues and get help. I did not consider what the laning phase would be. All I knew was like, okay, we'll have Lone Druid mid maxed up against the Wind Ranger. I do really like the fact that they're matching an aggro tri-lane against Terrorblade.
Yeah, look at bottom right now. Like, Swindles can't go bottom because he went for this Iron Talon first. So now he's in a position where they have to send somebody bottom. But at the same time, like, Z-Freak has to be moving around the map. This is kind of a lose-lose situation for Complexity because you don't want this Riki to stay static in this lane, but you don't want a completely empty lane for Batrider. That would almost just be a little bit too much. So now you've got a scenario where you can potentially win maybe three lanes out of three.
Yeah.
And that's pretty huge in itself. Yeah. I think mid Limp will do okay. But at the same time, like, it's a lone druid. It's very hard to kill this hero, and especially with the heroes that Complexity have, you're not going to get aggressive.
They held on to the Metamorphosis. They're actually going to be able to go on a Hanskin. Free pick off there. Riki actually makes the rotation across, so they might be able to get the turnaround kill onto Misery. Question is this fight actually going to continue to go the way of Cole? They now start going on to Resolution. Unfortunately, Swindles is not going to be there in time to be able to get the boar slow, so they can't really get any extra damage. One for one, but DC obviously winning that engagement. They forced rotation of two heroes into the lane, and they managed to get the first blood, and Metamorphosis is now down for Chessie, which leaves him hurting for CS in about 10 seconds.
And more importantly than that, they got first blood. You're okay with this one-for-one trade because first blood is always worth it.
Yeah,
and
for sure.
Look at the bottom lane right now, because they had to rotate the Riki up there. Like, this Riki is not a static hero. This is the, you know, he wants to be like water. He just wants to be formless, shapeless, walk around the map, do whatever he wants. But look at, like, Mu just farms. There's nobody in his lane. This is some kind of weird dream scenario where you have an empty lane against an aggro tri-lane, and they can't do anything about it. Like, yeah. It's very rare that this kind of game happens. I think this is the first time I've seen this in a really long time. Now, Mu's just going to play the greediest game alive, Cap. He's going to stack this camp for himself.
Uh-huh.
He's going to farm the lane. And Swindles absolutely can't go bottom still. This is not the type of setup that you wanted.
Is it so bad that Complexity switch up the lanes and put their duo here of Chessie and Hanskin bottom? They're probably just going to get chased around the map by DC, but do you at least try and make that move?
No, because Mu's still missing CS.
So because Mu is failing his last hits, you're okay
with
what?
God.
Oh god, it's happening.
Mu.
Shake it off,
Mu. I say this out of love.
48 base damage, ain't much to work with.
This is like when I watched, what is it? Mushi go for no stat items on Murana.
Oh yeah.
I was like, that is going to be impossible to CS with. He has one Ironwood branch. I can't even blame him. This is just kind of how this goes for Batrider.
Yeah, you feel kind of silly spamming Sticky Napalm on just an empty creep wave without a hero nearby, but maybe he needs to start doing that just to secure himself some easier CS, because he is not doing well in that department. 17-7, Riki will show right back up in that bottom lane.
The good news, though, is that Riki's getting a lot of levels. Mm-hmm. The bad news, though, is that you're getting levels on a Riki. Like, this hero benefits from some levels, but it's not the all-important level 6 that a lot of these supports have, right?
Right.
It's not like a bounty hunter where all of a sudden you're like, wow, we just got a free track. Mm-hmm. You get your ultimate that makes you slightly more annoying to kill. But all the same, Mu still has absolute free farm, free levels. I think in XP, it should be going the way of Complexity, just because they have a jungler and a guy at that bottom lane. So that does mean that DC have to make some sort of move up at top. It is kind of weird, though, that this Beastmaster is still so heavily out-farming a Batrider that literally didn't have anybody in this lane.
Beastmaster jungle, man.
That's
the era of Iron Talon.
This just shows you.
I know.
Don't even go to the lane, because this is literally slower than a free lane.
That being said, you said Mu was going to play the greediest game possible, and that is because he's going to be stacking up the neutrals, and he hasn't actually farmed that, or he farmed up half of it just now. So that'll help catch him up. Seafreak is going to get a... Oh, my God. Does he have this? I don't know. Mu, he's got no mana to throw out Sticky Napalm. Does Seafreak go for the dive? Here he will. He's going to go for this dive. If he actually gets this kill, it'll all be good, but one Sticky Napalm stack is all it takes to chase Seafreak back to the lane.
Pressure's on, man. I always find it... For some reason, I find it harder to CS when nobody's against me, because I just feel like I'm an idiot if I miss anything.
You get real tilted the moment you miss one.
It just feels awkward. And it's even harder on Bat, because you have 51 base damage.
Resolution. Oh, the level 6 comes in, and now the damage from Chessie should easily be able to obliterate Resolution. If I go look for more, Swindles just keeps on running forward. His boar was coming up soon, but now he's slowed down, so he doesn't even try it. He and Chessie will combo up, not just to kill the Life Stealer, but to farm up the hard camp too. Swindles makes his way back to the base.
All right, I lied. Everything was wrong. The Batrider farms slower than the Beastmaster jungle.
And now, Digital Chaos, seeing the level 6 on the Beastmaster, and Terrorblade is getting up there in levels as well. He just used Metamorphosis. They're going to switch up the lanes. They don't want to go back there anymore. They're going to put Resolution at bottom, and Batrider is going to be doing his thing inside the jungle.
This game's kind of messing with my perception of reality.
Capitalist was right?
Yeah, but I don't... For some reason, I don't think you should be.
We'll have to ask someone better at the game than us, then.
Who? You want to go ask LD?
I mean, he's right outside the door. I can ask him.
Is he? Just yell at L Dizzle?
Yeah, I mean, that guy's casted 3 TIs.
He really has been.
Has he? No, he's only casted 2.
He's casted 2.
All right, Toby's well, then we should be casting... We should be asking Toby.
Yeah, we should be asking Toby first. Dude, I can't even say that with a straight
Toby,
face.
Toby, you're a 3-time international grand final caster. Solve this conundrum for us.
Toby, as somebody who's owned the game longer than Blitz, how are you still 4,000 MMR below him? Just messing.
That's unfair, though. I think I have like twice as many games played as you, and I'm like still like 3K MMR below you or something.
All right, Resolution. He's like, that top lane was a disaster. Let's go bottom. They are catching up though in net worth. As soon as this lane swap happened, everything is looking up for DC.
Lin?
But unfortunately for them, Midas on Wii is going to be finished any second now. And that's going to be the item that kind of propels them forward. Because this Radiance is going to be super annoying for Complexity. Because I don't think they have a natural mech carrier. And they have no sustain if you look at their lineup. There's no healing from them. There's no dazzle on their side or anything like that. It's very hard for them to take the straight on engagements.
Right. Well, the drums soon. Misery palling up with Mu. Taking half the experience, see if you can get that level 6 a little bit sooner. While Swindle's at the bottom lane against Resolution and Soxa. He's not going to be alone, though. Z-Freak is making his way over. He's almost level 6. Not a hugely impactful level, as we kind of referred to earlier, but he might just be able to get the kill. In fact, he will. Soxa is going to go down, and Resolution can't even do this. In fact, he's got to maybe Infest Bomb his way or Rage TP. Double damage? Not enough. Limp. Can't quite finish him up, and we will be able to get the Lifestealer to safety, but still, they forced his TP back, which is still going to slow down his farm, and give Swindles another free lane.
Everything is going pretty well right now for Complexity. The pace of the game is okay for them, it's just there's an indirect pressure being put on them because Sloan Druid has a Midas now. Like, all these Midas carriers, what they do best is they put pressure on the enemy team to make a play. Because this Lone Druid's just naturally going to get
it. Speaking of making the play, Mu's going to try it. Oh no, the glimpse breaks and Chessie lives! And now Mu, he's in trouble.
Oh,
no, he's not. He's good. He's good.
He's got dust.
Oh, he's got dust. Z-Freak, Firefly. How much longer? It's not going to last much longer. And he's not going to be able to finish up with right clicks, I don't think.
Oh, just like 3 heroes that he couldn't kill.
Oh, nice heal bomb. Z-Freak's low.
Another dust?
Can he get the jump away? Oh, they actually managed to get him with the counterward. Mu, though.
Think Mu dying,
it's worth the death. Or it's worth the death of Z-Freak if they could get the kill on Mu. Shallgrave will be able to save him for the time being. Hanskin will just try and... Oh! It blows him up! Now Chessie, controlled up by Telekinesis, and Mu lives with a triple kill. Digital Chaos. Oh, that was chaos right there.
This mid kill, though. If they can get it onto Weeha, he thinks there's space being created, but they're going to sandwich him here.
They get the roar. Now he needs the perfect Savage Roar to stop this one, and he gets both. Is it going to be enough? Limp catches up, dodges a little bit of damage, but it's not good enough. Transformation is only going to stall the inevitable. And now Resolution, he's in a questionable position. He does get the rage and removes that slow. And speeds
thought
up
we
quite
had
a bit.
It for a second. With the Druid form, that would have been so cool, but yeah. That top fight is still very good for DC. Like, it gets
incredible.
So much gold. Helps their supports too. There are 2 supports were getting underleveled just because of the fact that they weren't happening or they weren't doing too much. And Misery and mid
Misery
is going
to be popped quite easily. Resolution. Nice TP out from Swindles. Gets a little damage from the Riki. Just looking for his escape. He'll be okay. Do you think that part of that top lane fight, that's got to be the part of the drums build, right? Like, that's kind of what the drums build allows you to do in lane. It just, you can just bully people.
Yeah, it's also just because you're a Batrider that has like 1200 HP, and you don't need the blink dagger this early on.
Yeah.
Part of the reasoning, I remember Lumi asking this question at the last hub, and everyone just kind of laughed at him, but it was like a really valid question to have, and I think it's mainly just because it's a shift in playstyle. Before, remember when Storms used to just go straight for the Orchid, mm-hmm. and they started going for the Bloodstone? The real reason is because if you go for that Orchid and you don't find pickoffs, you're really all in on the hero. Like, remember when Batriders used to get blink daggers? It was the most predictable play in the world, right? Yeah. You get a blink dagger around 8-9 minutes, you'd smoke, you go mid, try to get a pickoff. Every team started to respond to it. But now, with this Batrider with 1200 HP, a huge mana pool, a lot of move speed, like, this hero can be fluid. Like, you can do a lot with him. You can actually lane with him, you can jungle with him, you can pressure because you can catch up to heroes. Like, there's options now. You're not just pigeonholed into one thing.
I think one of the things I really like is he defends towers very well when he has drums. Because he's just so tanky, and he's a Batrider as well, which Firefly is naturally good tower defense as well. Yeah, he just fights so much earlier, so much better.
Yeah, exactly. Because a lot of this meta is about these huge team fights. You don't care about these individual pickoffs so much anymore, because at the end of the day, they don't matter too much. You care about these huge team fight engagements, like these straight up 5v5 fights. Having this like 1300 HP Batrider is so much more effective. But at top, who's gonna go down?
Yeah, caught out by Swindles. TP. Swindles will in turn, maybe. Oh, never mind. I forgot. It's a Rubick Dazzle. Doesn't really offer you a whole lot of kill power. So even if Swindles is low, unless he gets hit by a bad heal, they're not gonna be able to pop him. And now those two supports are gonna be the ones wrapped around on. Good cloak and dagger. Misery. Trying to buy himself some plays, but the steal doesn't really get him much, and that will turn into a tier 1. On both sides, DC, they'll be able to get the mid tier 1. Complexity will get the offlane tower, or maybe they won't. Limp has already TP'd in. Hanskin's looking to be able to get the glimpse back in. They're not going to find it. They're just going to have to maybe get a Spirit Bear kill, but not even that's possible.
Very well done by Complexity, and credit to Swindle so far. Like, in the first two games, I think he had a little bit of an off game, but in this game, 1-0-5, he's made a lot happen for his team out of this jungle Beastmaster with his rotations, and he's been the pace setter right now for Complexity thus far. But at the same time, Limp's about to be on his way to his Aghanim Scepter. He's pretty close to it. Swindles is going to get Necrobook 2. If we take a look at the Lone Druid's items, that's probably going to be what determines a lot of what DC decides to do next. Mm-hmm. Like, the sooner we decides to get his Radiance, the easier it is for them to move around.
So, because he's 1800 gold away, what does that mean for DC? They stay more passive? They don't try and group up just yet?
Yeah, they just relax, because all of these mini-engagements, it sucks for DC. Like, they're not happy about it. In an ideal world, you just don't lose heroes, but if you're doing what they're doing, which is like everybody is farming on the side of DC right now, it's bound to happen that you're going to lose one or two heroes. Like, their supports are flashing themselves all the time. Their cores are not farming together. Like, they're just split up on the map. Like, they're here, there, everywhere. You're okay with that because majority of your team fight is going to come from this Weehaw Radiance.
Right. Now, Complexity, they probably feel in that pace that you're talking about where DC is sitting back, they're kind of spread out, and they're going to try and abuse that. They are going to go for a smoke up, invasion into the jungle, get some aggressive wards up, and ideally get the pick, but they don't find anybody. They may still stumble into Digital Chaos running four-man smoke of their own. Hawk's going to go out, obviously. Not seeing anything just yet until the smoke pops. That'll be Swindle Mountain's going to be jumped on, and Hanskin will respond with the Static Storm, unable to really catch anybody there, and Complexity may just have to give up the one kill. Maybe two. Hanskin. Oh, the telekinesis stops him in time. And that will be two kills going the way of Digital Chaos.
And more importantly, space created for this Lone Druid, because every single time you get pickoffs like that, you just reset the clock a little bit more.
Yeah.
Chessie, though, is getting pretty huge.
Yeah, he certainly is. He just got a tier one as he cut across into the mid lane. He's got a Yasha, Dreads, and Ring of Aquila.
See, DC though, they're just letting Cole crash into them more than anything because they know that complexity with this Disruptor Ricky support combo and a Beastmaster, they're going to make moves around the map. So all DC has to do is let them run into them, right, and they can play passive aggressively.
Is there any reason...
get farms.
I mean, maybe they obviously didn't expect that rotation, but where was Z-Freak in that? Shouldn't he be the one really exploring the jungle and coincidentally would have popped that smoke?
Yeah, they're going to do that now, though. It's just one of those lessons that you mess up and you learn.
Yeah.
I think they should just hard get out of here. I think Misery even gets out. I don't think this is a tower worth defending for DC. They have to know that everybody's here right now. And Z-Freak's in a really good position. He's scouting them out. Unfortunately for Complexity, though, there's no trees. And now Moo's got special delivery.
They have the Cannon Wards. So DC should know all the information was there for Complexity. Complexity are going to choose to back out. Kind of surprising with the information they got. I actually expected them to go for it with Static Storm, just see what they could do, but apparently not. They're going to wait for maybe Necro Book 3 on the Beastmaster. They now have that Dragonlance on Chessie.
They're trying to just pressure and bully wherever this Lone Druid goes to try to slow down this farm and force him to go to the jungle.
Yeah.
And DC... unless they have that Batrider ultimate and the Lifestealer Infest, there's no way that they're going to look for any sort of pickoffs. Mm-hmm. And without the Infest available right now, again, you just wait. This is a very timing-oriented lineup, whereas Complexity's lineup is a lot more freeform in this regard, because they don't really have these huge cooldowns aside from Metamorphosis, and they don't really need the Terribly to fight either.
Running forward, Moo looking for the pickoff, and he may just find it. Nah, never mind. There's a glimpse away. Hanskin will very smartly TP out. Resolution can't stop him. Limp is looking for the pick at bottom. Didn't actually run into Misery's Rubick, and will instead run into a creep wave with counter wards everywhere.
Misery's going to force out this mid wave, this bottom wave. Complexity, they take it for free, and that's always going to be the trade. There's no reason to defend that tower.
Yeah.
The scary thing, though, is the Roshan, that yeah. Complexity you can just go in for, which they're going to as soon as they see this top tier 1 tower being taken.
Yeah, if you've got a decent Rosh-taking team, right, you always go for Rosh around anywhere at this point, right, before the Lone Druid has radiance. You want to at least secure yourself that advantage.
It's not even that. It's more when you're taking that bottom tower and you immediately see DC rotate top, then it's a free Roshan.
Yeah.
That's the real dire advantage. It's just... you're not really trading tier 1 towers, you're trading ground in the Roshan fights, because Wii's being shown, but at the same time, they pick up a free kill there, and I think this is going to signal Complexity to go down. DC, they can't really push off of this, though. They should connect with their Lone Druid if they're going to do anything.
Yeah, and in turn, Complexity, should they be pushing bottom, or do you think they can contest top?
I'm not sure. They do have Metamorphosis, but they have to heal on Chessie. And Chessie is in no position to fight right now. This is going to just be a free tier 2. It's really well read by DC, understanding that Complexity can't fight that immediately after doing the Roshan.
Mm-hmm. So DC perhaps getting the better trade. We'll have to see how that Aegis is utilized, though.
Yeah. Apparently you're muted, by the way, in Dota TV.
I think Dota TV is just really bugged right now. I legitimately think that it's just like bugging out.
All right.
Because you had problems, I had problems, and seemingly for no real reason. So I'm not sure what to say, homies.
Four staff completed on Batrider. Echo Saber on Lifestealer. They're going to find... not a very big pickoff, but kill is kill.
Yeah. Windranger did run into those counter wards earlier, but maybe you just assumed that they were down by then.
Yeah. So the early game lead that Complexity had off the back of just picking a little bit greedier has kind of melted away.
Yeah. Slight lead in both gold and experience. Nothing major going the way of Digital Chaos, but this is one of their stronger times with the Radiance fresh up, and they'll probably be able to
grow that gold lead with some further objectives being taken. As they are going to go for this tier 1 bottom lane, they're going to have the smoke on in. Limp is going to lead with a shackle shot onto the lone druid bear. Now the spirit bear is going to get controlled up by this kinetic field, but Complexity can't seem to fully commit.
Bear comes There's no back real angle for them. More. They've got to be careful.
Yeah, they could very easily run into
they
a bad
themselves
team
all
fight
now
here. Yeah, they get the Primal Roar onto the side. They're going to try and pop the Batrider. Static Storm actually chasing away the two supports, and they manage to get out of it. Chessie with the swap around. Resolution will die before he gets anything off there, and Moo, he'll be able to get away. Chessie still has that Aegis in hand, and DC, they're going to actually be able to lock him down. Weehaw, he'll lose his life as well. Complexity find the opening from behind. Swindles gets the Primal Roar to lock down the main initiator of Digital Chaos, and it all falls their way from there.
Resolution just got completely controlled up too. Like, it's hard for him to target anybody in that fight. Like, Chessie has so many free angles. If the Batrider dies there, there's no way that they can kill the Terrorblade with Lifestealer, because at the end of the day, he'll always sunder you. Yep. You can just take those hits, pop the sunder. They've only got two forms of control. The Rubick was kind of zoned out. Like, even though the Static Storm didn't catch anybody, it did something even more important. It just split the lines. I can't even believe, like, what happens if we get to a game 5? Complexity just got crushed in game 1 and 2. Like, that's the kindest way to put it. Then in game 3, they battle back. In game 4, they've got an advantage now. This Terrorblade is very strong.
Pretty intense. I mean, not the start. But it may be we reach quite the climax here in this best of 5 in our grand finals to determine which one of these two teams is going to be heading straight into the main event of the International, and which one of them is going to have to battle their way out through the wild card series. And we know from seeing the other teams who are going to be falling into those wild card slots, that is not an easy competition.
No, not at all. Now you're going to see Z-Freak pick up Diffusal almost. Like, this is not really a support Ricky. Like, poor Hanskin. His team's winning. He's got towers. They got Roshan, and he still only has 2k net worth.
He might just be able to find a kill. Oh, the Hawk got spotted. Never mind. Resolution. He's not going to chance it whatsoever. If he doesn't see that Hawk, maybe he pushes forward and they get the instant roar into Static. Static Storm that gets him killed, but not the case, obviously.
Yeah, Lone Druid has the Vlads now, not a massive pickup, but it's pretty standard. Moo's got a gem. It's probably going to be the biggest item so far that DC has picked up, because the vision game is so important for them. Their Ricky being able to assault the back lines is really going to hurt them.
Okay, so Aegis just went down. Aegis just went down. Is there... Do DC start getting aggressive? That extra life isn't there. You've got a Batrider Lifestealer combo. Lifestealer doesn't feel whole healthy with going late game against a Terrorblade. He's like, I'm not really going to do a whole lot there, guys. You start playing to your advantage now, right? You gotta start fighting.
Uh-oh. I think Terrorblade is going to be really hard to kill. Moo's not going to get shackled.
Shot. But he's going to be glimpsed. Pulled into this Static Storm. Misery just gets...
This is so bad.
Woo! Ripped a new one. Now they do manage to get the escape off the Shallow Grave and TP out. Moo will escape. These two supports will die. And Complexity just popped a Metamorphosis on DC's side of the base. They're definitely going for the push here.
If they could have killed Moo there, I would have... That would have been almost checkmate for Complexity's favor. That early pickup gem is so huge on their side. He's even going to drop it in base because he's worried about it now. But this assault is so dangerous for DC. Like, this is so difficult to hold.
All right. Smack it away. Complexity going for Chessie. They're going to be able to get one. Moo, they are going to try and make the initiation onto Chessie. Can't quite get him. Moo, his Blink Dagger's just not far enough, and Complexity will make the full retreat out. Unless the bear can somehow latch onto somebody.
Moo's got to find somebody for this. This is going to be a huge pickoff if they can get
anybody. Oh, he blinks forward. They caught him. Chessie
He gets off the Sunder. Can he turn this fight around, though? Resolution has to run himself away, and he's running right into the hands of Z-Freak. He gets off the Silent. Will be able to get the damage output to finish off Resolution. Unless he can Arbalest toggle. Gets one. Gets two. Z-Freak's not in range anymore. And now Hanskin, as well as Chessie, in some trouble as Moose starts running him down. Flame Break goes down on the side. Twindles ends up going for Misery. Now they get the control into Chessie. They'll finally be able to finish him off. Z-Freak will be able to get the kill on Moo. And Resolution, well, the Armlet toggle, it kept him alive last time, and it looks like he's got the faith to be able to do it again against Z-Freak. They get three of Complexity. You said they had to do it now, and they will indeed do it. Digital Chaos, they lost themselves a Tier 3. They lost the melee racks, but they find a big opening there with that kill.
You need to find something there, especially if you're going to lose racks like that. So they're going to go for the counter push. And Complexity, they should be able to hold this. Resolution is not in tip-top fighting shape. If they can just spam out, delay as much as you can.
Alright, you guys saw that? Rob just came in shaking his head. He has no idea. Sorry, guys. Don't know what's going on with Dota TV. Everything should be working, but hey, Gremlins invaded the BTS studio, and we still have a game for us to cast. I thought that was going to latch on to Weeha's hero. Apparently not. That latched on to Misery instead, so... They don't have...
They should chase her this.
Oh, yeah. They saw that TP out from the Lone Druid. They saw the TP out from Dazzle as well. Misery's not getting away. Unless... Oh, God. The Haste Rune! The Ice Frog appeared! Oh. Glimpse comes up just in time. He was almost out of range of that Glimpse.
Wow. 27-minute racks. And they got the range one, too, just by the passive creep sitting. That's another good chunk of change. Mm-hmm. And even though they lost a lot of heroes there, it doesn't really matter. Because racks are what you came for. Especially against a Terrorblade lineup. So Chessie pops the Metamorphosis. Free tier 2.
Yeah, trying probably to go into that one. I don't care if you're a Lifestealer. I don't care if you're a Spirit Bear. Yeah, you don't want to walk into that Terrorblade when he's got Metamorphosis out, Manta, and a bunch of other Conjure Image illusions out in the field.
He's got Scotty now, too. This is going to be very good against Resolution and the Spirit Bear. Yeah. The onus is now on DC to make the moves. That one swift, decisive fight, or Complexity catch those two heroes without buyback, then immediately go for the push. Potentially could have just won them the game.
Love it at 15, 28 minutes in. Things looking very good for Complexity in this game 4 as they look to be able to tie up the series 2-2. Digital Chaos are struggling to find the pick that gives them some control in this game, gives them the opportunity to determine the tempo as they're running around in this dire jungle, fruitlessly looking for a kill on Complexity, but they won't find it. Cole. They know, and I watched them play one of the safest games I've ever seen Complexity play. They seem to have taken their conservative play style to the next level when they start getting ahead. They don't risk anything they don't have to, it seems.
They shouldn't. They have this Roshan to fall back on because they're dire, and it's going to force DC to come into them. As long as Complexity just hold this high ground area, and they do what DC did in the early game, which is just let DC run into them. Mm-hmm. It's going to be very hard for Complexity to fight under. It was just that one fight at bottom, and then, or the two fights at bottom. By the tier one, that kind of just broke open the game. Then the subsequent fight where they lost the two supports, lost them racks. Yeah. Now this next Aegis is going to be huge in Complexity.
That's why both teams are smoking up and trying to fight around it.
Get the respective high ground. That's the important part.
Yeah.
Cole, no now, though. Yeah. They should send the Hawk forward, scout in. They'll see that DC's moving up, and now the Roshan's for free. DC doesn't have another smoke, I think.
Yeah, they see that bottom lane pushing out, and they know someone's got to go back and defend it. They're going to start doing Roshan now, as you said, they spotted DC moving on out. So now in Aegis, it seems... all but in the bag for Complexity. They just need to follow through now. A four staff for Hanskin, Aegis for the Terrorblade. We're going to have MKB coming in soon, Limp, so we don't even have to worry about that miss percentage chance of the Radiance. And Hero like a Lifestealer, especially against this team of this draft of Complexity, which has Lifestealer full countered. He's going to be feeling real ineffective unless Moo can find him the right kind of opening. I'm not sure what kind of opening that is, though. Because it's no longer just jumping on the Terror Blade and controlling him, not with the Aegis and not with his very tanky skill set.
He is so strong right now. Like, nobody from DC can really go into that. And Resolution just can't fight anymore. Like, they don't have the heroes that match course at this point.
Yeah.
So Complexity, they march their way down top. All their heroes have all the items that they want, respectively. This Ricky's got a Blink Dagger and a Diffusal, so now they have a way of locking Resolution up instantly.
Do you think this is the right play? They're not trying to do some sort of sneaky smoke initiation like we see oftentimes where you see the death push coming and you try and get the initiation here, like through the secret shop or something. They're going for the split push of Weeha in the bottom lane. Do they just not have a better option?
Yeah, but they're going to get Misery sent back.
Yeah, he's dead. Or not.
That's good.
Shallow Grave, he gets the save. Tier 3, that is not something you can save.
The top tower, it's gone.
The glyph,
this bear, is dead.
That's about to go down as well, Jesus. It has to go back to the fountain. They find the initiation onto Chessie. The glimpse is going to be able to stop that lasso. Now the reflection goes down. He managed to get the Sunder onto Soxa. That means Chessie, in pretty decent fighting shape, will be able to kill one before Resolution manages to get the turnaround kill. And here comes that Aegis. Nice jump out from Z-Freak. Manages to pop the ultimate. Spirit Bear does go down. Resolution tries to man fight up against Chessie. Physical damage from two different heroes, though, is beginning to overwhelm Resolution. And that's why he jumps inside the Spirit Bear. Pops right back out as soon as Chessie gets low. And they got him. They got him dead. Complexity are now on the run. And multiple heroes are low. They just need to be able to catch him. They stop Ponskin's TP. Look for Z-Freak on the side. They're burning him now, and we'll be able to have the wards and counter wards, and looks like Limp's going to go down as well. Moo was able to catch up with him. They get the triple kill on Moo, and a kill goes over to Lone Druid as well. They lost Tier 3. They lost another melee Rax, just like Deja Vu from the bottom lane. A very similar narrative where DC do pick up a lot of kills, but in the end, they are beginning to dwindle when it comes to objectives.
That was still a very good hold. They killed four. They killed the Terror Blade twice, which I didn't think they'd be able to do. But Complexity were so honed in on just getting that Rax, and DC just kept drawing them deeper and deeper into their base.
Yeah.
Are you laughing about the Hawk Steal?
Yeah. What an invis play.
I think in straight up 5-on-5 engagements outside the base, I think Complexity can smash that. But when it comes to just being inside your base, having the option to buy back, I think that's where DC are very strong. Maybe not so much anymore, because that Terror Blade was being really annoyed by that Radiance and things of that ilk.
Yeah.
He's now got a Blink. That
was actually absurd, by the way. I felt like he was missing way more than he should have. Like, when he, like, they had Misery caught out, and the damage was really slow to come out on him because he kept missing. So to Disillusions, Hanskin's going to be potentially picked here. They get the Force Staff out of the side. Misery, he's going to be trading his life for this one. Hanskin is going to hit by the Flame Break. He will take out from that one. Misery managed to get the Shallow Grave save. But more importantly, Chessie, he's going to be man-fighting with his BKB, trying to go for Weeha. Doesn't actually have enough lockdown. It seems the Scotty won't slow the hero down enough. And now Chessie's low. He's still got the Sunder. Swaps himself with Z-Freak. But his buddy, he didn't want to go out like that. Just gets popped by the Infest. And Chessie will still end up dying here. Digital Chaos just won a huge fight right outside the Complexity base and might be able to finally get a hold on the Complexity base and get some racks to their own favor. They don't even have buybacks. Terrorblade, he's got nothing. It's just going to be the Windranger and the Riki who are able to buy back, and Hanskin's Disruptor up in another 5 seconds. They're going to have to defend this base without their primary damage dealer, and that's going to be pretty rough. DC, they want to be able to claim everything they possibly can while the Terror Blade is still down. They get the Tier 3, pull back here, Static Storm latching in, Weeha. If they can actually kill him, this will stop the push. They jump in, Shalgrave will be able to stall things up, and Weeha will actually survive here. Resolution gets the jump on in, looks like the power shot missed, and Limp, he'll pay for it with his life. He just bought back two. 13 seconds till the Terror Blade's back up, and Z-Freak, he'll go down as well. How can a Terror Blade, can he actually stop this without any extra help? Oh god, look at the base, it's actually being torn up by creeps. Lone Druid, he'll buy back and defend this push. Terror Blade, He now comes in. He knows Mu. He doesn't have anything. The reflection goes down. Resolution starts fighting it out. He managed to get the infest inside a creep. Soxa. Force that back. What? Okay. Glimpsed in. Mu will be able to pop the BKB. He gets himself out. And which creep is he in? That one. Resolution. He pops out. Lojer is actually threatening the top lane. That's why they're leaving Resolution alone to go for the bottom lane. Weehaw, he already managed to get the kill. He's trying to slow down Chessy. Bottom lane, that will be the lane of Rax. Resolution forced himself away. Savage Roar goes down. Chessy, he desperately needs this kill on Weehaw. That was a buyback. They can't afford to lose Weehaw here, or else, oh no, they got the glimpse back. Weehaw, he's going to be left stranded here. He just starts heading for the base, heading for that last building, but he's not going to be able to make it in time. Complexity. They know 100 seconds on the clock for the lone druid. This game, it's gotten crazy, it's gotten chaotic, it's gotten sloppy for both sides. But Complexity, they were in the lead before, and now I think they're in the lead again, as they have the way to be able to force the 5v4 by just heading straight down mid and at the very minimum getting Megas, if not closing out this game. We'll have to see. The push forward is starting. He's going to be leaving a trail of fire, hoping to be able to just do anything he can at this point to slow down the push, to kill the creep wave. But that is just going to be a little trail of breadcrumbs that Complexity will follow all the way through into Digital Chaos's base and potentially into their tiebreak. They're looking at a 2-2 here in this series. The TP's coming in from Resolution. He will come in right into all those illusions. That is none of them real. Resolution just dies like that and instantly buys back. Mu, he didn't even get the right illusion either. Chessy, he's still alive, and he pops a reflection. Slowing down Soxa, will almost be able to get him before the Shell Grave comes out, slowing him down with the Scotty. But he remembers, objectives are the name of the game. Defense of the Ancient, they're going to take the Rax first. Start looking towards their tier fours. No, they're going to back out. 20 seconds until the lone druid is back up. Oh, good. Long range Sunder manages to hit the Rubik, and Chessy looking very healthy. But 12 more seconds till the lone druid is up, and they've got Megas. All they have to do is defend. But what a seal from Rubik. No, he did it. He dodged it. He dodged that glimpse back, and just like that, oh man, Complexity. They get out for free. That could have been the game saver there if they managed to get the glimpse and a pickoff. But now, Digital Chaos are fighting up against Megas and very likely have to just straight up five-man through mid into Complexity with some buybacks, I believe, left on Complexity. Is there any? Yeah, Terrorblade, he's got his. I knew there was at least one big buyback. Terrorblade being able to be on the front lines with this upcoming push. You're going to have to kill him once without Sunder being used, but how are you possibly going to be able to get him a second time after he buys back? You need to be able to finish out this game. The Mega Creeps are going to be too much for you to handle, especially with this Terrorblade coming in, but he's already slowing down the push so much. The Illusions running through mid lane. If they don't speed this up, the side lanes are going to start coming in. They're going to have an opening for Complexity to actually just go straight thrown with the Megas beating on the Tier 4s, Digital Chaos. Their five-man entry through the mid lane. They want to be able to push this out. They want to be able to finish off Complexity, make this a 3-1 victory. But this is going to be the toughest fight of their life. Chessy. Oh no, another. They managed to get the lasso on the lip. Okay, that's okay. But still, it's Chessy, the big boss, and managed to get off the Sunder. Resolution dropping low, and he goes down. Oh, he's dead, and there is no way they can output the damage to finish off Chessy at this point. Not with two lives, that's for sure. The Metamorphosis goes down. Okay, he used Metamorphosis. He's going to have to buy back here. He's going to try and TP into this fight. Weehaw still fighting strong, going in for Swindle Mounds. Chessy comes in. He's got the Metamorphosis. He's got the damage output to be able to solo this up. If he could just dodge all this damage and manage to glimpse away. Misery going to be controlled up by Z-Freak. They're going for the throne. They're actually going to try and finish off Megas themselves with Weehaw going for that building, but he can't actually finish him up. Chessy by himself is actually holding, and Weehaw, he runs himself away, but he's just desperate to find some other kind of opening. He's going to hide himself in the trees, has the boots of travel to TP back if necessary, but something tells me he doesn't want to let this go. He wants to be able to go for that top range Rax, and he goes for it now, but this may cost him his life as Z-Freak is already there. He's going to be able to jump in. Slows him down. Managed to get the kinetic field combined up with the silence. Miss percentage chance galore. Chessy's right there too. And sure enough, Weehaw goes down for 85 seconds. And how can you see a way for DC to hold now? 80 seconds against Megas. No buybacks left. And Complexity will play it the most conservative way possible. They're not going to march down mid. They're not going to risk their lead. They're going to go and grab themselves an Aegis and Cheese first. What an insane game number four here. Complexity, they had themselves quite the lead, but off of a pick in the mid lane, Digital Chaos gave Complexity a run for their money in this game number four, but it seems like all the advantages that Complexity got in this game, whether it was through their play, through their draft, whatever it was, it seems to be too much for Digital Chaos to be able to stand against. They're going to be sitting here inside their base, trying to defend to the last man. But this is looking like a Colonel Custer. They're going to stand here. They're going to fight up against Mega Creeps, but eventually they're going to be overwhelmed by Complexity. They've got the Aegis. They've got the Cheese. They've got the extra lives, and Digital Chaos do not. They start beating into the Tier 4 tower. The Roar comes out. Moo, he's going to be target. They want to make sure this lasso is not a successful pullback into the fountain. Meanwhile, Chessie's just going straight for the throne and conjuring as many images as possible with the metamorphosis. He just rips through the building, and they call it GG. Our series is going to a game number five. That was a butt clencher. But we've got a full series ahead of us. Boys and girls, don't go anywhere. Stay right where you are. Don't go to the bathroom. Don't go any food. Don't get water. Stay here and watch game number five of Digital Chaos and Complexity after a short break.